Okay, this might be the last video of this IBM for a while, but I just had to show this. I got my new network card for it, and a member, or actually an admin, of the Vintage Computer Forum made some interesting TCP utilities that are making this computer so much fun to run. Let's watch the boot. I did change my autoexec.bat back quite a bit. Helps speed up the boot speeds. And interesting that an XT class machine apparently has a unidirectional parallel port. At least that's what the hard drive controller detects. But it seems to work in that mode. Okay. Now we're loading some interesting packet drivers. Now we're doing DHCP. And now we're setting my clock. Yeah. Current system time is 1980. The time should be set to 2011 4:07 5 o'clock in the morning. And the IP that I'm going to is actually my domain controller, which is in there, that jungle mess. Anyway, this is what I really want to show you. That is an FTP server I'm going to run on this machine. It's running. Now all I have to do is load CyberDuck. Shows me as connected now. Let's adjust this a little bit. Alright, let's drag a file in there. Let's see, what do I want to put in there? I'll grab a file from here. Now why not a MIDI file? I don't have any MIDIs on my desktop apparently, I thought I did. Anyway, I'm going to drag a picture. I'd say these are pretty good file transfer rates, actually, for this machine. Completed. Now I'm just going to go ahead and delete that since it's not actually going to store it as a valid file name just because I didn't really make it such. So I'm just going to delete that file. And when I click delete, that was easy. Let's make a picture that I can load on this computer. First up, I'm going to find a picture to use. I like grabbing the wallpapers from this site. They look really good. And there are some that just make that screen really shine, even though it's monochrome. I think this one will look good. Mainly, what we need is a 320 by 240. Copy image, then load the GIMP, and we're going to convert it to a 320 by 200. Let me go ahead and close out CyberDuck. That disconnects, and I'm going to close the. Actually, I want CyberDuck open. Let me reopen that back up. Okay, good. File, create from clipboard. Now I'm going to scale it to 200, and I'm going to break the aspect ratio just because on the screen it's still going to show up as 4:3, so that's okay if it squishes it a little. Now we have that done. Image mode grayscale. File, save as. Let's call it water.gif. GIF files load the easiest on an 8086. Save. Let's interlace it just for the fun of it. They don't load really much faster, but it's just cool to watch. Alright, now I'm going to drag water into this. Complete. So now I'm going to close out a CyberDuck. Close out of that. Back over here now. Close the FTP server. Go to my share drive. Load CompuShow. It's gonna take a little while. It's just detecting free space on my hard drive. That was something I usually had pre-calculated at boot on my computer, and that's why the IBM took so long to turn on. I decided I can deal with it doing it later. And there's water. So I'm gonna select it, hit the space bar, because it knows which one to load. And here comes the picture. Gotta admit, that is pretty cool looking. Yep. I also have another picture on there, and if I see display comments, you can easily tell created with GIMP on Mac. So I have another picture I downloaded from the site interface list, which was this one. This one's a progressive GIF. Gotta love that screen. It's just cool looking. I'm gonna reload up my STP server because I'm actually gonna use it to store a file on that hard drive, which is a movie I'm encoding. Some keystrokes I have. I have a TSR that lets me blank my screen so I can keep the computer on, yet go to sleep without a glowing screen.